Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we talk about granulomatous inflammation. Granuloma is defined as a circumscribed tiny lesion about 1 millimeter in diameter, composed of predominantly of collections of modified macrophages called epithelioid cells and rimmed at the periphery by lymphoid cells. The word granuloma is derived from granule, meaning circumscribed, granule-like lesion, and oma, which is a suffix commonly used for true tumors. But here it indicates a localized inflammatory mass or collection of macrophages. Granulomatous inflammation is a distinctive pattern of chronic inflammation that is encountered in a limited number of infectious and some non-infectious conditions. Immune reactions are usually involved in the development of granulomas. Strong activation of T lymphocytes leading to macrophage activation, which can cause injury to normal tissues. Composition of granuloma are epithelioid cells, multinucleate giant cells, lymphoid cells, necrosis, and fibrosis. One of the best example for granulomatous inflammation is tuberculosis. Commonly we know this in India is the major country. Now it is under control because of the central government and state government routine checkup and investigations. Tuberculosis is mainly caused by the bacteria called Mycobacterium tuberculosis. This Mycobacterium tuberculosis hominis, that is the human strain, while Mycobacterium tuberculosis bovis is the bovine strain, used to be the commonest cause for tuberculosis. Mycobacterium africanum, isolated from patients from parts of Africa, will be seen. And there is one more, Mycobacterium microti and Mycobacterium pinnipedi and Mycobacterium caniti. These are the other common strains of tuberculosis. A non-pathogenic strain that is called as Mycobacterium magmatis is found in the smegma and as contaminated in the urine of both men and women. Mycobacterium tuberculosis hominis is a slender rod-like bacillus 0.5 micrometer by to 3 micrometer in neutral or gram staining. Other stains which are used to rule out the tuberculosis bacteria is acid fast staining, also called as ZN staining, Zill-Nelson staining. Sometimes we get false positive acid fast bacilli staining is due to the presence of nocardia, rhodococcus, or some protozoa such as Isospora or Cryptosporidium. Other dyes like fluorescent dye methods can be used to rule out the tuberculosis bacteria. Our culture of the organism from the sputum in LJ staining media for up to 6 weeks, that is Lowenstein Jensen staining. Even guinea pig inoculation method by subcutaneous injection of the organisms. Molecular method such as PCR are the most recent methods. Atypical mycobacteria or non-tuberculous mycobacteria can be seen in some of the incidences. So mode of transmission is through either inhalation, ingestion, inoculation or transplantal route. Spread of tuberculosis through local spread, lymphatic spread, hematogenous spread or other natural passages. Hypersensitivity and immunity in tuberculosis. Mainly this will be done by using tuberculin skin test, or also called as Montauk skin test, or immunization against tuberculosis, that is protective immunization against tuberculosis is induced by injection of attenuated strains of bovine type of tubercle bacilli, that is called as Bacilli Calmette Guerin, BCG. Or evolution of tubercle can be done. Types of tuberculosis. There are two types of tuberculosis. One is primary tuberculosis and secondary tuberculosis. primary tuberculosis, the infection of an individual who has not been previously infected or immunized is called as primary tuberculosis or Ghan's complex or childhood tuberculosis. In case of Ghan complex or primary complex is the lesion produced in the tissue of portal of entry with foci in the draining lymphatic vessels and lymph nodes. The most commonly involved tissues for primary complex are lungs and ilar lymph nodes. Ghan's complex in lungs consists of three components, that is pulmonary component. Lesion in the lung is the primary focus or Ghan's focus. It is 1 to 2 centimeter solitary area of tuberculosis pneumonia located peripherally under a patch of pleurisy in any part of the lung, but more often in subpleural focus in the upper part of lower lobe. Lymphatic vessel component, that is the lymphatics draining the lung lesion, contain phagocytes containing bacilli and may develop beaded miliary tubercles along the path of ilar lymph nodes. Lymph node component, this consists of enlarged ilar and tracheobronchial lymph nodes in the area drained. The affected lymph nodes are matted and show caseous necrosis. Fate of primary tuberculosis. The lesions of primary tuberculosis of lung commonly do not progress, but instead heal by fibrosis and in time undergo calcification and even ossification. Continues to grow and the caseous material is disseminated through bronchi to the other parts of the same lung or the opposite lung. This is called progressive primary tuberculosis. Bacilli may enter the circulation through erosion in a blood vessels and spread to various tissues and organs. This is called primary miliary tuberculosis, and the lesions are seen in organs like liver, spleen, kidney, brain and bone marrow. In lowered resistance and increased hypersensitivity of the host, the yield lesions of primary tuberculosis may get reactivated. The bacilli lying dormant in the acellular caseous materials are activated and cause progressive secondary tuberculosis. Thank you.